Hello Windows Universe. In this video we will talk about if the screensaver is not working on Windows. For a more in-depth look at the topic, we will link an article in the description down below. You should start by checking your screensaver settings. It's quite possible that the screensaver is turned off. This could either be a default setting or could have been changed after a Windows update. And some third-party programs are also known to alter these settings. So let's open the search menu. Type in screensaver. If the screensaver is set to none, the screensaver is disabled. In this case, you can choose it to any of the screensavers you want. You can select wait the appropriate amount of time to have the screensaver come on. Next, let's check sleep settings. If your sleep settings are set to turn off the screen or sleep before the screensaver can activate, then you'll never see it. Let's go to sleep and adjust it. You can say activate, say after 5 minutes, put my device to sleep. And you can make adjustments for these to go longer. Therefore, your screensaver activates. Keep your mouse clean and away from polished surfaces. The slightest movement of a mouse counts as movement for the system. If an optical mouse is unclean or kept on a polished surface, it will keep recording movements and therefore the screensaver might not appear. To isolate this probability, clean the bottom of the mouse and keep it on white paper for a while. If the screensaver still doesn't appear, then that's not the problem. Let's try to unplug the peripherals. When connected to the system, some peripherals like the printer or a touchpad or whatever might send a message to the computer that it doesn't need rest since the peripheral device is at work. In many cases, this instruction is encoded into the driver. In this situation, we can try unplugging all the peripherals and check if the screensaver appears. If it does, then plug the devices back in one by one to figure out which one is causing the problem. And then you'd have to decide whether or not to keep the peripheral plugged in when not in use. Perhaps there's something wrong with the power settings, so let's restore the default power settings. The screensaver is governed by the settings of the system. If a Windows update or third-party software messes with the power settings, the screensaver might not work. In this case, you can reset the power settings to the default. Open our Unbox and type in powercfg.cpl and click OK. Click on Change Plan Settings. Then click on Restore Default Settings for this plan. Click Yes. Restart your system, try the screensaver then, and see if it works. Use the Power Troubleshooter. The Power Troubleshooter can fix issues related to the power settings. To do that, you're going to click on the Start and go to Settings. Scroll down in System till you find Troubleshooter. Look for other troubleshooters. Find the Power Troubleshooter and click Run. Follow any on-screen prompts, restart your system, and see if the screensaver is working then. Let's look at updating in the display or graphics drivers. Go to the Device Manager. Look for the Display Adapters. Right-click and go to Properties. Then go to the Driver tab. Open the display or that. Right-click on it to open Properties. Under Driver, see if you can roll back the driver. If not, now you have two options. You can either click on Update Driver for this device, or you can go to the manufacturer's website, download the latest drivers, and install them that way. Try running an SFC and a DISM scan. To do that, open the Start menu. Go to the Command Prompt. Run it as an administrator. For the SFC scan, type in SFC space /scan now and hit enter. This will scan the system for corrupted files. It may take a few minutes. When that's finished, you'll want to run a DISM scan. To do that, type in DISM.exe /online/ clean up, one word, -image/ restore health, and hit enter. Depending on the level of corruption to your system, this scan could take a while, so please be patient. Once that's finished, type in exit and hit enter. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.